Hey everyone, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'll show you how to create a drop-down list in Excel. If you've ever used Microsoft Excel for gathering information through a form or a survey, you know that it can be difficult to control what people enter. One option for controlling the information people enter is to create drop-down lists that limit people to choosing from a list of options you provide. Making a drop-down list in Excel only takes a few minutes and will save you a lot of time in cleaning up non-standardized information. Now let's walk through the steps to create a drop-down list in Excel. Step 1. Launch Microsoft Excel on your computer. In this example, you can see I've got a form where I've got a couple of questions that I want to add Excel drop-down list for so I can control the options people can input as answers. Step 2. Click the New Sheet button along the bottom of the screen to add a new sheet to your Excel workbook. The New Sheet button looks like a plus sign. A new sheet will be created. Step 3. Double-click the name of the sheet to make it editable, and then name the sheet drop-down list or something else so you'll know what it is. It doesn't matter what you name this sheet as long as you know what's contained inside of it. Step 4. Create lists containing the options you'll want to include in your Excel drop-down list. In this example, I'll create 3 lists. One that contains the options I want to make available for someone to choose their favorite iPhone model, another list for someone to choose how long they've had their iPhone, and another list that contains options for a question around when someone plans on trading in their iPhone. At the top of each list, you should include something that indicates what values are contained in this list. In this example, I've included favorite iPhone model, phone age, and trading in iPhone. Step 5. After you're done putting information into the sheet containing your list values, go back to the sheet where you want to actually create the drop-down list in Excel, and then click inside of one of the cells where you want to add an Excel drop-down list to select that cell. Step 6. Click Data in the menu above the ribbon toolbar to display the data options in the ribbon. Click Data Validation in the Data Tools section. The Data Validation window opens on that screen. Step 7. Select the Settings tab and then click to expand the drop-down field beneath Allow. Click List in the list of options. Step 8. Click inside of the field beneath Source that appears in the Validation Criteria section and then highlight the cells in the corresponding list on the datasheet you created. That cell range appears in the Source field. Click OK. When you click in the cell where you added the drop-down list, a drop-down arrow appears on the right side of that cell. Clicking that drop-down arrow will display the items you choose to include in your Excel drop-down list. Choosing any of those options populates that item in the drop-down list. In this example, I'll choose iPhone XS. As a note, you can easily delete items from the drop-down list you create by deleting them from the source list. However, if you add an item to any of the source lists that you want to include in a drop-down list you've created, you'll need to select that cell, go back into the Data Validation Editor, and then modify that cell range to include any options you added. Alternatively, you can remove your created Excel drop-down list at any time by highlighting the cells containing the drop-down list you want to remove, navigating back to the Data Validation Editor, clicking Clear All, and then clicking OK in the Settings tab. The Data Validation Editor will close and you'll be returned to the cell that previously contained a drop-down list, where you'll now see that the Excel drop-down list has been removed. Let me know what projects you plan on using Excel drop-down list for in the comments below. If you liked what you saw here, click the video link on the right side of the screen to check out another video. Or click the logo on the left side of the screen to subscribe to this channel to see more great videos like this one.